It's not an adaptation of the novel. It's a documentary, experimental documentary about the museum, and it's going to give you a sense about the museum. So let's start with the video. It's directed by a British filmmaker called Grant Gee.
There is a story to tell every time people and objects meet. Stories exist within time. That time I bought this white handbag. That time I picked up this salt shaker. That time I dropped this earring. That time I saw this newspaper. That time I kicked this red ball. That time I wound that clock. That time I looked at this view. There is always a story to tell. I was looking out of the window when I saw this crow. I was crying while I washed my hands in this sink. A boza seller walked down the street while I was listening to this radio. I thought of her while I looked at this ship. I was in love with her when I picked up this cigarette butt. Then there was another cigarette, followed by another cigarette butt, and another. And all those cigarette butts are now a sort of calendar for the museum. A timeline of Kemal and Fusun's love story.
So that's one vitrine from the museum that I'm gonna show you later again. And Orhan Pamuk, published a novel called The Museum of Innocence in 2008 in Turkey and opened the museum with the same name in 2012 and later published a catalog that you see all of them all together here. And I'm going to talk about what he did there. The novel takes place between 1974 and mid-1980s and it covers the second half of the 20th century in Istanbul. It's a love story, but it doesn't put love on a pedestal, rather it tries to critique it almost anthropologically as something that happens to all of us. And the way we behave towards love gives a lot of cultural details. It's almost like a comparative humanity work. For the museum, it's not like once he wrote a novel and it was successful, then he decided to make a museum based on that. When he started to think of the novel, he was already thinking of the museum. This was around mid-1990s. He bought the building that you see here, the museum's building, in 1998. I can tell you, museum is not the illustration of the novel, nor the novel is an explanation of the museum. There is a connection between those two, but it's not an old-fashioned connection text and in its illustration. It's more complex. Idea was in the beginning to open the museum at the same day when he was publishing the novel. Also, the first form of the novel is a sort of annotated catalog for a museum where the annotations are so long and so much manipulated, in a way, it is read like a novel. Then he changed his mind and he published the novel like an old-fashioned 19th century novel. I'm going to give you briefly the story of the novel. The hero, Kemal Basmacı, is an upper-class man from Istanbul, and he's falling in love with his twice-removed cousin just before engaging with a proper girl, meaning a girl from his own society, class, culture. And just like the Turkish melodramas and the films, the novel is describing a lot. Poorer girl is marrying to another man. Our hero is very upset and visits this house that you see in the slideshow of married girl, this house of the married girl, posing like a well-meaning uncle or a sugar daddy for almost a decade. And since he is frustrated by the fact that she's married to another man, he collects objects that are significant, suggest relationship that reminds him of her and piles them up somewhere else. Actually, he's stealing most of the time from the house when he comes for the dinners for to meet her. The novel and the museum and the catalog is a distinction between gathered objects and collections. They all ask the question, what makes gathered objects a collection? The idea of museums and encyclopedias, so and so forth, these are the issues that are addressed both in the catalog and the novel. And I told you the story of the novel more or less, and because of the political pressures and financial issues and time problems, Mr. Pamuk couldn't open the museum at the same time when he published the novel. And he found out that's going to be the case, so he focused on the novel more and published it and continued to work on the museum after publishing the novel. As I said, the first object of the collection is this building. He always had the idea of setting a story in a real existing building in Istanbul and then manipulating the story in such a way this building in the end turns out to be a museum, and making it and opening was the whole project. He always jokes about it. When he told this to his friends, they said, okay, don't do it. I mean, you are a writer, you have to write your novels. And he started to not to tell his friends this idea after a while. And this building is situated in Çukurcuma neighborhood in Istanbul. And once the building was decided, the neighborhood would have influenced the class, the lives, and the details of the characters of the novel. What I'm going to show you is the first version of the building. He found this building in this rundown neighborhood, not far from his writing studio, actually. He used to take his daughter to school walking through this street. These are two photographs. One is from 1890s, taken by Abdullah Brothers, and the other is taken by Orhan Pamuk himself in late 1960s. He was taking pictures by the age of 17, 18 to make paintings out of them. He wanted to be an artist between the ages of 7 and 22, as he describes in autobiographical book Istanbul. And so you see, like, there aren't many differences in between those views from the neighborhood. So these are two images from the same neighborhood again. And the top one is taken by Orhan Pamuk himself. In 1969, actually, and the one on the bottom is 2 years ago, it was taken by Orhan Pamuk. In the last 40 years, the neighborhood changed a lot. Istanbul got richer and much more crowded. We are now inside the museum. Building was the first project of first object of the museum, and there would be thousands of objects in there. He wrote the novel by looking at all these objects that you see inside the museum. And he was going to open the museum with all these objects of the characters of the novel touched, and they must tell a different story, and they had to create a different mood. So it would be smart to find the object first while he was writing. Fisun, the main character of the novel, wore this dress that you see on the right top part of the image when she was taking driving lessons. He was writing by looking at these objects. And sometimes he found an object at a place so that it triggered his imagination and went ahead with this story. So what is this? It's a quince grinder, actually. This is a typical example. In the middle of the novel, there's a chapter Mr. Pamuk wanted to address the problematics of the 1980 military coup d'etat in Turkey. But at first, he didn't have any idea how to do that. One day, there was a flea market around his neighborhood, and he found this object. You may imagine during the military coups in the city, there are military checkpoints all around, and they search for handmade weapons. And after seeing this quince grinder, he decided to use to illustrate how soldiers mistreat you after 11 p.m. on the streets, and the character actually stealing this from the house and putting in his jacket, and the soldiers are finding out what is this, and they are like questioning him a lot. So you see various objects from the museum. Lots of cups placed here. Coffee and foods are not real, by the way, in the museum. The more he collected, the more neatly described them and put in the novel. Another view from the museum. There's a flea market, actually, 3 minutes from the museum. I don't know if you've been to Istanbul. There are like that old old antique stores all around the museum. There were like slight curating in the beginning when he started to work on the museum. Now people are like making more curating in their stores, in these antique stores. When he finished the novel, his flat in Istanbul was already full of objects, and he kept for the museum and wrote about them in the novel. But the museum wasn't done yet. So there, I mean, the question arose in the museum, inside the museum. There were like strong ideas, but what would be the logic, the system of putting the objects inside the museum? You see, the final output of the museum here, he made a major decision. He would put the objects following the chapters of the novel. The novel has 83 chapters. The museum, as you see here, would have 83 boxes, as we call them vitrines, cabinets, as they call them in Europe. Each chapter has a chapter heading, such as Merhamet Apartment. So the seventh chapter of the novel is Merhamet Apartment. And when you come to the museum, you will see the seventh box is called with the same title. And all the prominent objects that are described in the novel are placed in these cabinets. You see on the corner, there is one more floor up and one more floor down. This photo is taken from the second floor of the museum. And the boxes are not realistically, but sentimentally following the logic of the novel and the story at the same time. This is to give you an architectural sense of the museum, the first floor. So let's go to the boxes. What took the most time was placing in the boxes the objects that Orhan Pamuk collected in 8 years of writing the novel. Objects were coming from so many different sources, and how to put them in the boxes that would look nice was the question. Having the collection is not that important at this moment. For example, he collected the matches that the people in Istanbul used over years, but we couldn't find a way to look them nice, exhibited nice in the museum, so they are not in use, exhibited at the moment in the museum. He says in the museum, things should look nice together. Exhibiting them like in a government museum was not something that he wanted. There is also a manifesto about the museum, a modest manifesto for a museum. On the webpage of the museum, you can see that manifesto that is written for the museum about the small museums. So then he began to do these drawings. He drew when he was writing the novel, actually, this one. And he says this is a lucky chapter because he drew it and put the objects together in the way that he drew, and it worked. As in creative writing, you plan something and it doesn't work, but you persist, you go on. This is actually one of the reasons there are 4 years difference between making of the museum and the publishing the novel. The title of this box is My Father's Death. Protagonist's father dies. All the senses of guilt, father, power is illustrated by this little desk side table. Mr. Pamuk's father's generation, fathers, had this kind of bedside tables, and all these papers, photos were there as well. And since the protagonist also deeply in love and suffering, the glass of rakı that you see in the center of the image, a hard liqueur, is the cure for his love pain. We see a lot of rakı inside the museum in the boxes. So this is another box, different than the previous one. Drawing didn't work for this box. And Mr. Pamuk defines this box process as in creative arts, try and error. You plan, but nothing works, and you put the things together again and again and see, and then go on until it is working. Intellect cannot see pleasures of accidents and surprises. There is something accidental happening in artistic work. You try so much, finally you find something beautiful. For 5 months in 2011, in his life, for the first time, he didn't write anything. And he spent almost every day in the museum by making the boxes inside the museum. You see another box here. Here exhibited the cluttery room atmosphere of upper middle class in Istanbul during the years of the novel. Because of real low real estate tax, it could be seen that there were a lot of houses where upper class people kept their old things, and lovers meet in these places. Another cluttery place, rusty old objects, old clothes. In front, you barely see, but there is a handkerchief and a belt that are signifying things about male sexuality, fragility of female sexuality, and this make possible these things come together. While working on the museum, Orhan Pamuk saw a new generation of collectors emerging in Turkey, especially in Istanbul. The country was getting richer, and these new collectors weren't interested in old Ottoman things, but more in their own private childhood things. And their behavior is interesting because of that. And these are the photos of film stars and footballers from 50s and 60s. This is a collection that I really like. It's the collection of old boat photos from Istanbul. I love this box a lot too. This box corresponds to 14th chapter of the novel. It's a good example to express how he wrote the chapter and did the box. First, he found the photo of this little place on the Bosphorus in Dolmabahçe and decided to incorporate this to both museum and the novel. So he set a scene of a novel in this place and made this composition with the objects that are used in this chapter. You see another example here. The protagonist of the novel, Kemal, is infatuated by the love and says to the reader in Orhan Pamuk novels, characters are directly talking to the reader most of the time. He says, "Here I exhibit a broken heart." Objects in the Museum of Innocence can be divided into three categories, actually. Some of them are ready-made. Those are objects which already exist in culture in daily life, and Mr. Pamuk found them in flea markets or in old shops. There's a second category, the objects that are produced with the help of other artists. There's the first fruity sodas bottle, and it was produced for the museum. Its newspaper ads and commercial film was done. And there's a third category of metaphorical objects. Here you see broken heart, of that expression many languages have. This is another box, box 28. This box is about women's virginity, women in Turkish media in 60s and 70s, how the society is repressive to the woman. There's a very nice passage in the book that, I mean, if you read the book, it's my favorite part in the book, I think. So, for your information. There are a lot of photos in the boxes, and Mr. Pamuk loves this photo. He enlarged it in the box 47, that of my father that you saw before. Here are soldiers are drinking rakı, Kemal's father, the protagonist's father in this picture. And the soldiers are so powerful and proud of being soldiers, and it's about the Turkey's situation in the second half of the 20th century, how the country is like controlled by the soldiers mostly. To make allusion to the history of art was another way of composing boxes. Here it is like 17th century Dutch still life paintings. Again, you see a lot of plastic fruits here, making a composition that alludes to other things, we can say. This is a box Mr. Pamuk gave a lot of time. It's how people of Istanbul celebrate New Year's Eve. Since Turks changed the calendar recently, this was a new development. The way the whole nation started to enjoy their bingo, Italian tombala, in New Year's Eve, all family come together and in a Western way. And all these little objects are gifts of the game. This is one of the most ambitious boxes in the museum. There are 2,413 cigarette stubs here. Protagonist Kemal is collecting these cigarette stubs of his beloved for 8 years, actually. Museum and the novel is about communication where boy and girl cannot meet as easily as it is today in Western countries in the years of the novel. So the whole set of gestures, words, all set of rituals developed to make communication between two sides. The cigarette is a good symbol here, like how you are like giving message to the other side through smoking, through the objects. And you see a detail from the cigarette. And these are not real tobacco, by the way. In 6 months, the real tobacco gets spoiled. So we produced these fake cigarettes for the museum. Under each cigarette stub, there is a handwriting of Kemal Basmacı's notes of individual night that he picked them. And Orhan Pamuk wrote these notes under the cigarette stubs. This is a box of the death of another father, but there are like some class differences between those two characters in the novel. From this box, this is an object that Orhan Pamuk loves a lot too. This watch from the previous box you saw about the complexities of Turkish calendar, because Turk used lunar calendar, then switched to European one. Somebody produced a watch, one side Western and the other is Eastern, and Roman and Arabic numbers. And this is the last thing actually I'm gonna tell. Museum of Innocence has a philosophy of time as well. More or less it corresponds to the Aristotle's idea of atoms. As we all know, atoms are irreducible part of things. You cannot break them apart. He also thought of moments. Moments cannot be broken apart. If you connect them, that line, actually it's a spiral here, will be the time. More or less, the Museum of Innocence argues that every moment corresponds to an object. And if you connect those objects, you will get a story. And of course, that story is about the objects. And I mean, the advice from the Museum of Innocence is mostly about having a collection and making the story related to those objects, and how you bring things together inside the museum with the objects and with the story is something that we are very proud of at the Museum of Innocence. Thank you very much.